What's going on my YouTube videos? I'm Jacob with another movie review for you guys and continuing on in my series of Richard Donner reviews. In today's video, I'll be taking a look at the 1975 TV film, Sarah T, Portrait of a Teenage Alcoholic. Finding herself unable to cope with the divorce of her parents and the stress of daily life, 15-year-old Sarah Travis starts drinking in secret. At first, alcohol provides comfort and release, then it sends her life spiraling out of control. Sarah T, Portrait of a Teenage Alcoholic, was released in 1975. This was actually a made-for-TV film that Richard Donner directed in between his theatrical releases, Lola and The Omen, which will be my next Richard Donner review. Sarah T was a movie that I almost skipped initially when I set up my director project on Richard Donner, but then I saw he directed this made-for-TV movie. I then saw that the movie was available to watch for free on YouTube, and free would be another way to check out another Richard Donner film, especially paying tribute to Richard Donner since he just recently passed away. So those were the three reasons why I decided to add Sarah T to my Richard Donner director project. And I'm glad I checked this one out because this is actually a pretty solid movie, come to find out. The movie does tackle a lot of dark subject matter. It is very dark when you're depicting alcoholism in movies and the negative consequences of that. Billy Wilder did that exceptionally well back in 1945 with his best picture winner, The Lost Weekend. And now Richard Donner is tackling this subject matter in a made-for-TV film, but with a more downer approach as it dives into teenage alcoholism, which, yeah, that's a little more darker than a grown adult diving into it. It's still messed up, but when a teenager drinks it, you know it's going to get even crazier and very sadder to watch because of that, because, yeah, you don't want teenagers to get into that habit, but it does happen with our main character, Sarah T, who is played by Linda Blair. Yes, the possessed girl in The Exorcist is our main character, Sarah T, who becomes addicted to alcohol because of some of the depression that she's had after her parents' divorce and how lonely and isolated she feels after moving after the divorce. So there's definitely a lot of sad layers to this story. Linda Blair gives a really good performance. She was definitely an exceptional child actress back then, especially if you've watched The Exorcist. She was so creepy as that possessed girl. But here she plays this depressed teenager who drinks a lot. And she has a lot of range in this movie, and I really like that. You definitely see the relatability of the character, even if you might not have had a drink in your life. But I know people, and I've been in situations where I felt low and I felt depressed and you feel like you can't control that. Thankfully, I didn't get into drinking, but even if you haven't had a drink or not, I think you can relate with Sarah's struggles when you hit lows in your life and you think you're trapped and you can't get out of it. And Sarah's story, I thought overall, was actually very gripping and compelling. What's also interesting is that Mark Hamill is also in this movie. Mark Hamill plays a character that provides a lot of support for Sarah T, kind of like the boyfriend, love interest type character. Yeah, I will admit the age difference is a little bit on the creepy side, as Mark Hamill is definitely way older than the 15-year-old Linda Blair. But Mark Hamill still gives a really good performance. It was one of his first acting roles. This was before Star Wars, by the way. So Mark Hamill definitely proved why he was a good actor early on in his career. And you can see how he went on and did bigger and better things after the release of this movie, like playing Luke Skywalker, for instance. I will say what holds Sarah T back is its made-for-TV trappings. If this movie had a bigger budget and it was theatrically released, I think Richard Donner would show off, I think, his directing skills a lot more, because as a made-for-TV movie, the filmmaking, the direction, The cinematography isn't on par with some of Richard Donner's other films. Also, some of the supporting cast, the acting is a little bit stilted and a little bit on the cheesy side, and it did take me out of the movie a little bit. However, when you're looking at the drama of this movie, it's impressive that Richard Donner was still able to pull this off, even with a low made-for-TV budget. I think because the performances were so good, the drama was very gripping, and it was very devastating to watch at times. I think what he was able to pull off is greatly commendable. I think this is a really solid movie. It's not as gripping as The Lost Weekend. The Lost Weekend had better filmmaking techniques. That's a movie I'd rather rewatch. I think there's a lot more layers of that film. But I do respect what Richard Donner was going for, telling this very sobering story about how messed up it is for a teenager to get into drinking and how that messes up your life and the people involved. I think Richard Donner did a great job with that. I think this is a movie that I think should be shown, honestly, in middle and high schools, because I think this would be a good movie to help prevent underage drinking, if I'm being honest, because I think it does its job very well, the negative effects of alcoholism and also how to overcome depression. I think it does its job very well. Even though some of the acting can be a little cheesy, the 70s dialogue and lingo is definitely there. It can be a little cringe at times. And it's not the best made movie on a technical level because it's made for TV budget. But I still respect what Richard Donner was trying to do here. And I do think this is a rock solid film in Richard Donner's filmography. And a pretty underrated hidden gem in Donner's filmography as well. I'm curious where this film's going to overall be ranked when I do my Richard Donner ranking at the end of this director project. But for now, I was pleasantly surprised by this movie. I thought this film was actually pretty good, considering what it set out to do. So at the end of the day, I'm going to give Sarah T., Portrait of a Teenage Alcoholic, a 4 out of 5 stars. And on the 100-point scale, it's getting a 73 out of 100. So that wraps up my review of Sarah T., Portrait of a Teenage Alcoholic, as part of my Richard Donner director project, where I'm going through his complete filmography from his directing debut to his last film. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're a fan of Richard Donner, I'll leave a link in the description below where you can check out some of the other Richard Donner reviews I've done on the channel so far. At the time of this video, for my director project, I've only reviewed Richard Donner's earliest films. I've reviewed films like X-15, Lola, and Salt and Pepper. I'm just about to get into the movies where Richard Donner broke big and became an A-list director. Definitely be on the lookout for those reviews coming in the near future. But if you want to check out my past Richard Donner reviews, feel free to click the link in the description below to see more. And don't forget to click the subscribe button and notification bell so you can be notified of future Richard Donner reviews. Join me next time in my Richard Donner director project, where I'll be taking a look at the 1976 horror film. I would say easily the film where Richard Donner first broke out as a director, the horror classic, The Omen. I saw this film for the first time last year for my 8 Nights of Fright Halloween series, and I'm excited to revisit again and do a full-on review for The Omen for my Richard Donner director project. So be on the lookout for my review of The Omen coming to the channel very, very soon. But if you've seen Sarah T., Portrait of a Teenage Alcoholic, let me know down in the comments below what you thought of the film. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Were you mixed on it? But whatever your thoughts are, please be civil and respectful of others. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Click the subscribe button to see more content and the notification bell next to it so you can be notified of future videos. If this is your first video, besides movie reviews, I also do TV reviews, ranking videos, and other fun stuff along the way. I have some more videos planned for you soon. Hope y'all have an amazing day. God bless, and I will see you next time. Goodbye!